Okay, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. So now this will be, you know, hadith session, inshallah. Because, you have to basically get the 40 hadith of Nawawi. So you have to do it on your own. And after you have taught so many times, you have to get some recording, maybe some from Faisal somewhere. So go through the 40 hadith. Because in exam, there will be exam of 40 hadith as well, of Imam Nawawi. That time I don't teach because I've taught so many times. And then hadith basically also, so 40 hadith are now, you know, it's all virtues and, you know, good actions, what piety is. So people need to learn. Then there are other type of the hadith, those hadith which basically are like foundation of the rules or rulings, ahkam, like, you know, which fuqaha use, like Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi, how they drive, like what is fard, what is wajib, what is sunnah, what is mustahab, what is haram, what is makruh, these things. So there are hadith like that, you know, this category, hadith are the fiqh basically. So there have been many, many books on that, and also there are smaller books which the beginners can learn, and then after that they memorize them, and then they read the more advanced work. Among the smaller books are like one, you know, Undatul Ahkam by Al-Hafidh Abdul Ghani Al-Maghdasi. You know, I don't want to write because it's I wrote a Muqaddimah as well, so you know, everything is there. So he wrote Undatul Ahkam, many people teach that. And also the later, you know, period, one book became very famous is Bulugh al-Maram by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, which I myself studied in Madrasa, the whole book. And it is more than 1,000 hadiths, you know, it's long, it's not so small. There are always people have been asking me long time, not now. Many Madrasa in this country, they ask me that, you know, there's no book on Ahkam, you can't do Hanafi Madhab. You know, because Umdul Ahkam is Hanbali, and Bulugh al-Maram, the author is Shafi, though they include hadith of other Madhab as well. But there's nothing written from the angle of the Hanafi people. So that was my thinking long time. Then actually I realized also another problem in these books, in the Bulugh al-Maram and Umdul Ahkam. What happening is, you know, Bukhari and Muslim, you know, it is everybody knows they are the most sound books of the hadith. Hadith, they are sound. But if you only can find out the sound hadith in these books, if you understand their methodology, if you don't know really, sometimes what you actually are taking from them, they are not sound. So for that, Muslim, rahmullah ta'ala, his way is that in every chapter, he will bring the hadith of the top hadith, the most important one, that actually is the sound hadith. Then he will bring those hadiths which are not so, which are not so strong, and they will not come in Sahih Muslim on their own, but they have come as support. They support the So this is how to fard. To fard basically means which is obligatory, and it's being obligatory is based on a very sound argument from the Quran Sunnah, means firm. That in theory, do not really practice all the time like that. When theory fard is, you know, something to obligatory, and its evidence must be firmly from the Quran or from Sunnah, very firm. There's no doubt about that. Wajib is also obligatory. But it could be that its evidence is not so firmly known. There could be some doubt, some, you know, weakness somewhere, but it is also obligatory. Further, why both are obligatory? The only difference is this one, the source for this one is firm and it has no doubt, and this has some doubt somewhere. Mandub is things which are not obligatory, but they're recommended. People actually are in